Hello, in this video we are going to be considering the difference of two squares. Now we know that in mathematics, a squared number is a number that is raised to the power of 2. For example, 4 is a squared number because 4 can be written as 2 to the power of 2. 9 is a squared number because 9 can be expressed as 3 raised to the power of 2. And of course, we can extend it to x squared because x is x times x, so it's also a squared number. So the difference of two squares basically establishes a relationship between the difference of two squared numbers. So for the sake of generalization, we are going to consider two squared numbers or two square items. So I'm going to have x squared as the first squared number and y squared as the second squared number. And we know what difference is in mathematics. Difference is a subtraction. So the difference of two squares is going to be x squared minus y squared. X squared is the first squared and y squared is the second squared number. And the negative here is the difference. So this is going to be x minus y in parentheses, then x plus y. This is the difference of two squares. X squared minus y squared equals x minus y times x plus y. Now this has lots and lots of applications. So let's apply this to solving one or two problems, to factorizing one or two problems. For example, let's apply the difference of two squares to factorize x squared minus 49. So here, x squared is already established. So 49 can be written as 7 squared. So it's obvious that y is 7. So applying this, we're going to have x minus 7 brackets x plus 7. That's all. Okay, let's take another one. A little bit complicated this time around. X squared minus 9y squared. Now, this doesn't look like a difference of two squares, but it is. What we just have to do is, already we have one square on the left part of the negative sign. So we are going to retain that. Now, we are going to do something here. Now, 9 is a squared number, so it can be written as 3 squared. And already we have y squared. Now, we're going to recall from indices that xy raised to the power of a is equal to x to the raised to the power of a times y to the raised to the power of a. So we are going to adopt this. So this tells us that 3 squared y squared can be written as 3y or squared. So we can see that this represents the difference of two squares. The first one is x squared, the second is 3y or squared. So we are just going to pick one here. This is x minus 3y, then x plus 3y. This is our final answer. Okay, a third one. This is a little bit complicated. 2x squared minus 50. So here, 2 is neither a perfect square nor is 50. So we cannot immediately apply the difference of two squares. So the first thing we have to do here is to factor out the common terms in 2 and 50. And that's 2. So 2x squared divided by 2 is x squared. 50 divided by 2 is 25. So we can see here that what's within the parentheses can be resolved using the difference of two squares. So this is 2x squared minus 25 is a squared number. So that's 5 squared So applying the difference of two squares, so this is x minus 5 times x plus 5. Perfect. Okay, one final one. That's example 4. So let's take 1 minus 100x squared. Of course, we know that 1 is a squared number, so this can be written as 1 squared minus 100 is a squared number, that's 10 squared, and x squared. So the next thing is going to be to merge 10 squared x squared. So this is going to give 10x all squared, going by what we did earlier, this law of indices. So clearly we've got the difference of two squares. The first squared is 1 squared, and the second square is 10x all squared. So this is just going to be 1 minus 10x within parentheses, and 1 plus 10x within parentheses. Yeah. So this is the difference of two squares and a few applications. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.